Division. When an integer m is divided by an integer n, where n is a divisor of m, the result is always a divisor of m. For example, when 30 is divided by 3, where 3 is one of its divisors, the result is equal to 10, which is another divisor of 30. If n is not a divisor of m, when an integer m is divided by an integer n, then the result can be viewed in the following ways. The result can be viewed as a fraction or as a decimal, where the fractions and decimals are useful when the result must be viewed as a single number, or the result can be viewed as a quotient with a remainder, where both are integers. Quotients with remainder are useful for describing the result in terms of integers only. Regarding the quotient with remainder, consider the integer m and a positive integer n, where n is not divisor of m. For example, when 17 is divided by 5, the result is greater than 3, since 3 times 5, that is 15, is less than 17. But the result is less than 4, since 17 is less than 4 times 5, that is 17 is less than 20, because 17 is 2 more than 3 times 5, that is 17 is 2 more than 15, as 3 times 5 equals 15. We say that the result, when 17 is divided by 5, is the quotient 3 with remainder 2, or simply 3 remainder 2. Therefore, 17 equals 3 times 5 plus 2, where 2 is the remainder, 5 is the divisor, 3 is the quotient, and 17 is the dividend. The dividend is the number that is being divided. The divisor is the number that the dividend will be divided by. The quotient is the number of times the divisor will go into the dividend. And the remainder is the integer less than the divisor, a leftover after dividing the dividend by divisor to produce an integer called quotient. Therefore, we can write dividend is equal to quotient times divisor plus remainder, where quotient times divisor is equal to the greatest multiple of the divisor, which is less than or equal to the dividend. When an integer m is divided by a positive integer n, therefore, the dividend is m and the divisor is n. We need to first find the greatest multiple of n that is less than or equal m. That multiple can be expressed as the product qn, where q is the quotient and n is the divisor. If we represent the remainder as r, we can write m equals q times n plus r, where m is the dividend, q is the quotient, n is the divisor, and r is the remainder. Therefore, the remainder is equal to m minus that multiple of quotient and divisor, that is R equals M minus Q times N, where R is the remainder. And the remainder is always greater than or equal to 0 and less than N, where N is the divisor. Twenty-five divided by four is 6 remainder 1. 6 remainder 1. Since the greatest multiple of 4, that is less than or equal to 25, is 6 times 4, or 24, which is 1 less than 25, as 6 times 4 equals 24. 90 divided by 45 is 2 remainder 0. Since the greatest multiple of 45, that is less than or equal to 90, is 90 itself, as 2 times 45 equals 90. Which is 0 less than 90, as 90 minus 90 equals 0. In general, the remainder is 0 only and only if M is divisible by N, where M is the dividend and N is the divisor. Five is divided by 20 in this example. So 5 divided by 20 is 0 remainder 5. Since the greatest multiple of 20, that is less than or equal to 5, is 0, which is 5 less than 5, as 5 minus 5 equals 0. Minus 46. Divided by 4, where minus 46 is the dividend and 4 is the divisor. So minus 46 divided by 4 is minus 12 remainder 2, where the greatest multiple of 4 that is less than or equal to minus 46 is minus 12 times 4, or minus 48, which is 2 less than minus 46, as minus 46 minus minus 48 equals 2. Division by 0 is division where the divisor or the denominator is 0. Such a division can be formally expressed as A by 0, where A is the dividend or numerator. The expression has no meaning, as there is no number K equals A by 0, which when multiplied by 0 gives a number A, where A is not is equal to 0, and so division by 0 is undefined. Thanks for watching. Perceive, persevere, practice. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thanking you from Higher Study Prep.